During the last general election, the polling company Salvation found that over the 3 days leading up to the polls, about 750,000 parents had changed their voting preference over fears about schools funding. The Conservative government appears to recognize the electoral dangers lurking around this issue and uses every opportunity to reiterate that per student funding will be higher in 2019-2020 than it was in 2015-2016. According to a report by the National Audit Office, the increase in per student funding will amount to a paltry £72 over 4 years, which, when adjusted for inflation, represents a real-terms reduction to schools' budgets to the tune of £3 billion. The government says schools need to find efficiencies and cut waste. Last year, a leaked report revealed that a quarter of Brighton and Hove schools had budgets that were in the red.
Our schools are hugely precious to our communities, and we want the government to fund them properly. And in spite of the fact that the government says that they care about our children's education, they are essentially starving our schools from the funds that they need.
Local grassroots campaigns such as Save Our Schools UK has been mounting pressure on the government to make up these budget shortfalls urgently. The Save Our Schools campaign has put up these banners in schools around the city, and it lays out essentially what each school and each pupil is going to suffer by way of cuts. And according to this, it says that each school is going to suffer somewhere in the order of over £190,000 in cuts. And that's teachers, that's computers, that's dining room tables, that's all sorts of things that would benefit students in schools. Now, according to the Save Our Schools campaign, the government can immediately reverse these cuts and properly fund our schools. Jambos Kumwobo for Latest TV reporting.